Okay, everybody. So I was just waiting for everyone to come in so I don't have to like repeat myself or anything like that. Hello, everyone. Anna Carolina, Anna, Russia, Virgilio, have you been to this class before?
Yeah,
Okay.
I met Jerry Poole.
Okay, great. I just wanted to make sure. Not a very common name, but okay. As usual, so I sent you the link to the document. There are going to be three of you. And really, write about everything you want and write as much as you can, unless you're like really fast. Usually, if there are three students in the class and I give you until like 35 past the hour, that should be enough time to really write as much as you can. And the only person I've ever like not gotten to everything before was Anna Carolina. Usually I can judge and be able to get through everybody's with the amount of time in the end. So does anybody have any questions? Does anybody have any, I don't know. Does anybody have any questions? Anyone have any questions? Okay, cool. So please take your essay and copy paste into the class document. Here's the link again. And again, let's see, 07 right now, and only three signed up. That's a really great number. Let's do 35 minutes past the hour. And that's it. I'll see you then. All right, so let's begin. Turning a new leaf. It was my 28th birthday's eve, and I was looking at the mirror at myself and thinking of my life. My oldest sister had told me I should quit smoking. She said, I know you feel well, however, when you turn 30, just turn 30, everything, comma, everything will change. Here you could put maybe one of those dashes. Your skin, your energy, everything. I thought, I don't think so, I don't want to quit. I was quite upset because I was aging and I really don't want to get old. I don't want to turn 30, my God. So how about semicolon here? If it's a complete clause, it's a semicolon. I don't want to turn 30, my God. She told me, okay, you need quotes here. She told me it is not a big deal. There are some upsides on it. Semicolon. If you have a complete clause, semicolon. A complete clause is one with a subject and a verb that follows. We become more mature and we care less. Okay, this is so long that we should probably just start in a new sentence. We become more mature and we care less about others' opinions. Others should probably be S apostrophe because this is plural. We care less about others' opinions, we are more confident, less self-indulgent, etc. And I was thinking, well, I am not that mature, I still care a lot about what others think about me, maybe it's, okay, semicolon. Again, complete clause. Maybe it is time to change. So, I took stock of my life and I decided to come back to school. Come back to school, well, better would be to say go back to school. Because come means like the school is here. Go back to school. That was a life-changing decision. My husband did not support that, and I was kind of, past tense, fed up with him. He smokes all the time, period, or semicolon. He complains about everything, dot, dot, dot. We had gotten married so early on just because I was pregnant, dot, dot, dot. I was wondering if I should carry on the relationship. One day, I met a guy, period. He was understanding and such a killer. Very handsome, semicolon. He was understanding and such a killer. Very handsome. Okay. And I went out for a coffee and to talk about medicine, but we ended up making out. It was the straw that broke the camel's back, and I asked for a divorce. My boys accepted that well, even though it was a difficult transition. Now I am almost finishing college, and I am happy because that key decision allowed me to have a fresh start. I quit smoking. I am more self-confident. And I have... So high self-esteem is non-countable. Just say high self-esteem. I study hard because I am self-disciplined. I am living with my new boyfriend, and I will be a doctor soon because I could get away with some subjects I had studied before. Good. So I guess I found happiness, and YOLO is my model, my motto, YOLO, YOLO. I say that all the time. We just live once. We have to be happy and to leave a legacy. We just live once, semicolon. We have to be happy, and no two here. Two implies like we want or we should or we might. It needs a linking verb. We just live once. We have to be happy and leave a legacy. Sometimes tough decisions seem to be wrong, but they are for the better, and we have to be brave to have the guts to turn our lives upside down. All right, good. Okay, Pollyanna. This book is inspiring and suitable for all ages. It is about a girl who was brought up by his poor father until 12 years old. She was longing for a doll, and she received a pair of crutches.
Yes.
She started crying, but her father taught her that the happiness game, and from that point she commenced to see the positive side of everything. She went to a small town to be raised by her bitter rich aunt when her father passed away. She changed people's lives, plural.
This book is a story for children, and it is very old-fashioned, but in my eyes it is timeless, and it is like a self-improvement book. I recommend it for everyone. Okay, very good. Okay, which I had never imagined that I could do it some, that I can do someday. Today I was on cloud nine, comma, as I had just bought. Had would be preferable because it says that this happened before you were on cloud nine. Today I was on cloud nine as I had just bought a new piano, which had I had never imagined that I could do someday. Possessing the first piano makes me recall about my journey. Normally people start playing piano when they are so young, about 6 or 7 years old, because this instrument requires at least 10 years to play beautifully. Thus, when I began learning piano early this year, my family and friends told me that it sounded fancy, as no one would catch up this dream. That told me that it sounded fancy. Fancy is, are you sure fancy is the right word?
I mean, it's not real. You're not realistic when you start that.
Oh, it sounded fancy. Well, fancy is a little bit different from unrealistic, maybe. I mean, I'm not going to check it out, but maybe unrealistic sounded like a long shot is the way to say it. It sounds a little bit far-fetched. Far-fetched is another way you can say that, or a little overreaching, maybe. Overreaching. Fancy just needs to be a little bit more clear. As no one could catch up on this dream when they are. When they are busy with working and family. Initially, those words discouraged me somehow, but I decided to keep my mind and go my way. Good. Until now, I have been learning piano for nearly 1 year. When practicing, I make a lot of mistakes, which entertains my neighbors but frustrates myself. This should actually be me. It frustrates me. Because the subject is it. If the subject was I, it might be myself. But right now, practicing piano entertains my neighbors but frustrates me. When practicing, I make a lot of mistakes, which entertains my neighbors but frustrates me. However, I still keep doing it again and again. Then a miracle happens when I can play the difficult songs in a nicer way. Even though it hasn't paid off yet at this time, it pays to persevere in practicing to be a good player, I suppose. Good. From this matter, I conclude that however old you are, whatever you do, just be brave. Brave enough? Just be brave to start it. Just be brave. I think it sounds better to say brave enough to start it. And don't be afraid about the journey don't be afraid about the journey because every cloud has a silver lining. This expression is lining, not lightning. Every cloud has a silver lining. The lining is like the outside, the lining of the cloud, like the outer part where you, like, the, you know, if you drew a cloud, the outline would be the lining. Okay, so I'll go back and reread everyone's if there's time in the very end. I just want to get through. Okay. Virgilio, The Catcher in the Rye, summary and comments. If this were to be a subtitle, they would both be kept. The Catcher in the Rye. This story is about this teenager, Holden Caulfield, this family was so wealthy, but from a very, You can say the family was so wealthy, but that doesn't make sense to say from a so wealthy family. The story is about this teenager, Holden Caulfield, from a very wealthy family who doesn't fit in any school, and he always gets kicked out from. So you can say the school he gets kicked out from is, but it would sound a lot more natural to say he always gets kicked out. Okay, he always gets kicked out, or you can also say he always gets kicked out from the school. Or he always gets kicked out of, even better. He is not able to focus on studying and pass his exams. Even better would be to say he's not able to focus on studying nor pass his exams. He is neither, so not this and not this. This would be a much smoother way to say what you're saying. And very formal. He is neither able to focus on studying, nor, it's always the way neither nor goes. He is not interested in anything and thinks almost everybody around him is phony. He seems to be smart enough to pass them. Okay, so pass. So you need to not say them because you have a sentence here about everyone in it. You have a sentence here about everything else. So maybe you should definitely take that sentence and put it up here because it has something to do with his exams. He is neither able to focus on studying nor pass his exams. He seems to be smart enough to pass them, but the thing is, he has no interest in them. So, no interest in them. He always has to follow something like that with a direct them, meaning the exams. He's not interested in anything and thinks almost everyone or everybody around him is phony. It might seem he is unsociable and has no friends at all, but actually, he may get together. He may get people together to socialize. He may get people together to socialize. Maybe it isn't at all, but actually he may get people together to socialize. But the truth is, deep down, The truth is, deep down, he finds imperfections in almost everything. Either they are phony or snotty. Either they are noisy or lousy. Okay. Those are incomplete clauses, but I like the way they sound. Okay. It might seem he prefers to be alone, but actually, he keeps calling up different people along the story to get together with. How about this? Different people as the story goes on.
It sounds better.
The book goes on to get together with. He could feel depressed and upset, and maybe that is why he tries to eliminate that feeling from himself, though he's not capable of connecting with people, except he finally ends up finding some imperfection, Okay, let's just stop there. No except, that means, except would mean that you would have to attach that to the other sentence. He finally ends up finding some imperfections in other people. Imperfections do not suit him. He really has no close friends. Finally ends up, or he continually continually ends up. You're saying that he finds imperfections in people all throughout the book? I would change this to continuously, because he constantly does it. It's not that he only does it in the end. He spends the entire book feeling very critical of people. Continuously or consistently would be another word to say that. Consistently ends up finding some imperfections in other people that do not suit him. He really has no close friend. It seems like he is such a lonely boy that cannot have any good feelings for anything or anybody that everything bothers him. On the contrary, he has a very close relationship with his younger sister. You can feel the love Holden feels for Phoebe and how he tries to keep her from his worrying. In addition to that, Holden seems unable to get over his brother's death, and you can notice how Holden misses Allie and how often he would like to talk to her. Allie, is that a girl or a boy?
Allie is his brother.
Okay. Now, you can notice how Holden misses Allie and how often he would like to talk to him. Okay. Since he is not supposed to get to his home until is sort of slang or shortened, until this is the formal form. Oops. Until Wednesday for Christmas holidays, Holden must spend some nights in New York hanging around. One of those nights, he ends up meeting a prostitute at his hotel. He had no intention to do that, but one thing leads to another. He feels uncomfortable with the prostitute who wants to come to the point so quick. Holden is becoming more and more depressed, and it seems that he just wants to talk to the prostitute and no longer get laid. Finally, he opts to not fucking her. Yes. Or he opts to not fuck her. You see that he prefers to keep his virginity for someone else, and losing his virginity is important for him, that he could,
it's important for him.
Do you mean losing his virginity to a person that's important to him? This, like, idea contradicts. So he does not lose his virginity, but then you're saying it's important to him.
Yeah, we deduce that losing his virginity is important for him. It's an important event in his life.
So we might deduce that losing, and yet he chooses not to lose his virginity here. Are you trying to convey that it's important that he loses his virginity to somebody worthwhile?
Well, he wants to keep his virginity for someone more important in his life. So that's why in the next sentence I say he could want to keep it for a significant person or a significant time.
Okay, so this is unclear, so let's change this. We see that he prefers to keep his virginity for someone else. That he prefers to keep his virginity for a significant person or a significant time. This would be more clear. He has such a fascinating chat with Phoebe when he decides to sneak in his own house without his parents' knowledge, since he has been hanging around in New York after he was expelled from this school, Pensy. During that conversation, Holden tries to explain to Phoebe that it is not his fault not fitting in any school, because most of the students are too phony there. So Phoebe asks Holden if there's just one thing he is interested in, and after some minutes of hard thinking, Holden discovers a sort of job or duty he could be interested in. He would like to help children not to fall down in a cliff. Meanwhile, they are playing on the rye. He would be the catcher in the rye at the edge of the cliff. By that time, he realizes Holden sees himself fitting in the world, carrying that duty out. Okay, so subsequently, Holden pictures himself going away from New York to the West where nobody knows him. He thinks he can work in a petrol station, just filling tanks up. He would like, it would be a low-level job, but enough for him to earn some dough to feed him himself and spend and rent some place to stay. The story Holden is telling us finishes right there. It seems he's staying at a sort of mental illness facility. Ultimately didn't go west, and he is supposed to go to school next autumn. The last idea of the book is that Holden doesn't really know if he feels like going back to school, but as he thinks, you won't know till you get there, but he thinks he will. Okay. So that's it, guys. Please, any questions right now?
Norelle, I'm sorry. What about me? I wasn't able to copy-paste it there.
I don't know. We are out of time. I guess you can send it to me. Maybe I can get it here. Sorry.
Sorry you said?
You can send it to me by email, and maybe I'll get to it later, okay? I gotta go now.
Oh, thank you. You mean on Verbling email?
Yeah.
Thank you. Well, it's not too long.
Okay, I have to get to it later, all right?
Okay, I'll do that, Norelle. I don't know, it's just, it never.
Thank you, goodbye. See you. See you.